Despite the chilly temperature, it was all smiles at the corner of Ida B. Wells and Plymouth Court today. Just a few hours earlier, Ida B. Wells Drive was still called Congress Parkway.
It passed in City Council in July of 2018, and so between then and now, there's just been anticipation of actually seeing the physical signs.
That sign means a lot to Michelle Duster. Ida B. Wells was her great-grandmother.
It just feels really good, very affirming.
Duster is working on a book about her great-grandmother, a story that begins with Ida B. Wells being born a slave in Mississippi, freed by the Emancipation Proclamation, who then became a teacher, then a journalist. And despite many threats to her life, she used her power to investigate lynchings across the country.
Saying at one point, brave men do not gather by the thousands to torture and murder a single individual so gagged and bound he cannot make even feeble resistance or defense.
When her work forced her out of the South, she moved to Chicago, where she lived in Bronzeville, and where she began to work on the suffrage movement, saying it's either all of us or none of us.
As we travel down Ida B. Wells Drive from this day forward, may those words ever ring true for us, that wherever we are trying to go, we want to bring others with us.
On civil rights, Wells was a founding member of the NAACP and worked to desegregate schools. She died in 1931 at the age of 68.
She is a timeless soul whose acts still reverberate today through each one of us. She's one of those forgotten heroes.
Her name and life's work is recognized at the National Memorial for Peace and Justice in Alabama, but now she's getting recognition here in Chicago. Recognition, many say, has been a long time coming.
From now on, along with George Washington and Christopher Columbus and John Kinsey, we will include in the telling of Chicago's history the story of a great woman, the story of a great person of color, and this is cause for celebration indeed.
And you can already find Ida B. Wells Drive on Google Maps, and it's already got a nickname. People are just calling it the Ida B.